Hello friends, welcome to Tech StudyCell. From the thumbnail you have already knew, in this video we are going to do some experiment with the electrolytic capacitor, which I not recommend you to do it in home. But I am making this video just to make you aware why should we be very careful while working with electrolytic capacitor. In this video we are going to use these capacitors. In our first experiment we will connect a DC electrolytic capacitor with the wrong polarity, which is a very common mistake we generally do while working with a DC electrolytic capacitor. For the first experiment I will use 220 microfarad 25 volt DC electrolytic capacitor and a 12 volt DC power supply. So let me connect this capacitor with the power supply, but I am connecting it in wrong polarity. And in the multimeter you can see the voltage across the capacitor. Now I will turn on the power supply and let's see what happens. Wow. So we have observed what could happen if we connect a DC capacitor with the wrong polarity. Let me show you the condition of the capacitor. You can see the top portion of the capacitor is inflated, which indicates this capacitor is damaged. So you cannot use this capacitor in your circuit. Now we will do the same experiment with a 2200 microfarad 25 volt capacitor. And again we will feed that DC 12 volt with the wrong polarity. So let me connect this capacitor with the power supply. And again in the multimeter you can observe the voltage across the capacitor. Now if I turn on the power supply, you can see the voltage across the capacitor is showing minus 12 because we have connected it in wrong polarity. So I hope after watching this you will be careful while working with a electrolytic capacitor. During this experiment I have taken proper safety precaution, but I will not recommend you to do it in home as it may cause fatal injuries. Again I am going to show you the condition of the capacitor, and again you can see the top portion of the capacitor is inflated. Now if I compare it with the good capacitor, you can see here the top portion is inflated. And for this good capacitor the top portion is flat. So thus you can identify the good capacitor by looking the top portion of the capacitor. Now if I want to measure the capacitance across this capacitor, you can see it's showing 600 microfarad. And the nominal value of the capacitor is 2200 microfarad. So you cannot use this capacitor in your circuit anymore. We all should use proper resistor while discharging a capacitor. But if you don't use resistor, what could happen? In this experiment, first I will charge the capacitor. Then I will try to discharge the capacitor without using any resistance. I will directly connect these two terminal of the capacitor for discharging it. In this experiment, I will use this 4700 microfarad 25 volt DC electrolytic capacitor and a AC capacitor of 30 microfarad 440 volt. And again, I will not recommend you to do this experiment in your home. This is just to make you aware, you should always use resistor while discharging a capacitor. So first I will use this 4700 microfarad capacitor. Now I will charge it with a 15 volt power supply. Let me charge the capacitor just by connecting the positive to positive and negative to negative. And after some time, the capacitor will be totally charged. Now we are trying to discharge the capacitor without using any resistor. We will use the screwdriver and directly connect the positive and negative terminal of the capacitor. So let's see what happened. You can see there is a spark. I have taken proper safety precaution while doing this experiment. The spark could damage your eyes, so be careful with it. Now I am going to discharge this 30 microfarad 440 volt AC capacitor. But before discharging it, let me show you the voltage reading across the capacitor terminal. I have selected the DC voltage in multimeter and you can see it's showing 300 volt across these two terminals. So it is always recommended to use a proper high voltage resistor to discharge the capacitor. But in this video, I will show you what could happen if you don't use a resistor for discharging this type of capacitor. So for that, I will use this insulator screwdriver. And if I connect these two terminals of the capacitor, I hope you have observed the spark, which can really damage your eyes. So it is always recommended to use proper voltage resistor for discharging this type of high voltage capacitor. So in this video, we have seen what not to do with the electrolytic capacitors. And I will request you to share this video with your friends, so he or she will not repeat the same mistake which I have shown in this video. If you find this video helpful, please hit the like button and subscribe our channel, and you can also press the bell icon to get notification for the upcoming videos. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.